Hello, I'm Jeremy, and welcome to another episode of Jeremy Yu's Music Reviews. I listen to music and you hear my thoughts. Well, we're back once again for round two of the worst songs of 2023. Let's not waste any time and get back into the action.
The toxic gossip train, you're chugging down the tracks of misinformation. The toxic gossip train, you got a one-way ticket to manipulation station.
My fifth worst song of 2023 isn't going to one specific song. Rather, it's instead going towards an entire genre that was absolutely inescapable this year. An absolutely horrid and obnoxious genre known as regional Mexican music. Before I start with this segment, I have a couple disclaimers. Firstly, if you like regional Mexican music, that is perfectly fine. Everything I state in this segment is just my personal opinion. So if this genre does something for you that it doesn't for me, great. Secondly, I do not even remotely have a problem with the music being in Spanish. There are several Spanish songs that I like, such as Mia by Drake and Bad Bunny and In Da Ghetto by Skrillex and J Balvin. The fact that the music is in Spanish is honestly the least of its problems. And with that out of the way, let's begin. Starting off with the production, I just hate the way that regional Mexican music sounds. These songs try to go for a more acoustic and homegrown feel, but just come across really bland at best or annoying at worst. The horns are either incredibly muted and generic or incredibly annoying and obnoxious to the point where half the time the horns literally sound like they're farting. The flow and melody feel incredibly lopsided, making the listening experience feel like I'm on a cruise ship about to vomit from seasickness. And the production itself just exists in this weird gray area between being too bad to be good, but not bad enough to leave an impression on me. It's just really lackluster production all around. The vocals also suck. Even though there are several different people in these songs, they all sound the exact same. They either sound incredibly bland and forgettable or whiny and obnoxious, combining with the already grating production to make these songs absolute misery. Easily the worst of them is, unfortunately, the biggest name in the regional Mexican music field, Peso Pluma. I just do not like this guy's voice at all. Not only does his music perfectly personify everything I hate about regional Mexican music, but Pluma just comes across as a whiny teenager. And not in a fun and enjoyable way like TX2, more of a pathetic sniveling way like Black Bear at his absolute worst. I don't know what it is, but everyone in these songs just sounds so annoying and soulless. As for the lyrics, yeah, there's not much here. Now, even though the lyrics are mostly in Spanish, the lyrics I've heard translated are pretty meh. Just incredibly generic and basic sentiments I've heard in a ton of other songs, or lines that just make no sense and don't fit with anything. And even if they weren't, it's not like these lyrics would save these songs in any way. Bottom line, I hate regional Mexican music and hate how big it was this year. The production is bland, the vocals are obnoxious, and the lyrics are nothing. And the thing is, if it was just a couple songs, I wouldn't have a problem with it. I would just be like, okay, this genre isn't for me, and move on. But no, there were so many of these songs, charting throughout the year. It was inescapable. Every time the charts updated, there it was, another boring and generic regional Mexican song. Rather than a song that made me feel something, there they were, boring regional Mexican songs appearing again, and again, and again, and again, and again, and again, continually diluting this year into nothingness and giving me nothing to talk about. That's why I'm giving the spot to all the regional Mexican songs rather than picking just one. On their own, they're completely inoffensive. Tolerable, but nothing I'd go out of my way to listen to. But when collected into a group, these songs form one gigantic amorphous blob that stuck itself to this year like a parasite. If you like regional Mexican music, good for you, more power to you, but I honestly just can't stand it, and hopefully in 2024, we get far more interesting musical trends. Next.
The toxic gossip train. You're chugging down the tracks of misinformation. The toxic gossip train. You got a one-way ticket to manipulation station.
So Drake released a new album titled For All the Dogs. And it wasn't bad. Far from amazing, but it had some decent tunes, solid features, and was an overall pleasant experience. But do you want to know the best part of For All the Dogs? Drake actually had the foresight to not put this garbage track on the album.
Come and rescue me. Take me out the club. Take me out the trap. Take me off the market. Take me off the mess.
Search and Rescue is the second most soulless thing Drake has ever made, only behind Grease. Starting off with the production, it is just so boring. Just a generic piano line combined with insanely limp trap skitters that never change. True Love was a posthumous song, so at least that had an excuse for not having the best production. Whereas this has none. It's not even fun production to talk about. It's just so limp and boring. It makes the song such a chore to sit through. As for Drake, wow. Drake hasn't always sounded the most lively and energetic, but on Search and Rescue, he genuinely sounds like he's falling asleep. His cadence is just so disconnected and dispassionate to the point where I'm not entirely unconvinced that this is how the recording session went.
Drake, get in here.
Come on, guys. I was in the middle of a nappy.
Don't care. We need to get this song out. Action.
Come and rescue me. Blah, 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 blah. Something about Kim. About the effort I expected for a song like this. As for the lyrics, yeah, it's standard Drake fare. A bunch of bland and dumb lines delivered really poorly and a really odd but equally bland sample of a conversation between Kim Kardashian and Kris Jenner that took place on an episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. Yeah, just by this description, I've put more thought into the song than Drake did. Overall, Search and Rescue is one of the most nothing songs I've ever heard. Not one person who made the song made even the barest effort to give, like, the illusion of trying. The production is too bland to be JCPenney's music. Drake sounds like he's napping in the recording booth. And I'd accuse these lyrics of being AI-generated, but that would be insulting to actual AI. I have heard interludes that felt more like songs than this obnoxious, droning drivel. And the fact that even Drake himself realized this song was too awful to be on his album should really tell you something, given the quality of certain songs he does allow to be on his albums. This segment doesn't even deserve a proper ending. I'm just going to cut it off here.
The toxic gossip train. Chugging down the tracks of misinformation, the toxic gossip train. You got a one-way ticket to manipulation station.
Wait, why'd you stop? You didn't think you'd just be a bumper song, did you? Get back here.
Toxic gossip train. Tie me to the tracks and harass me for my past. These rumors look like facts if you don't mind the gaps.
Yeah, I wanted to do that after I saw Todd do it to ABCDEFU in his Worst Songs of 2022 list. Anyways, if you've been on the internet for any length of time in 2023, you probably know the context behind this. But for those of you who don't, this is Colleen Ballinger. Colleen is most known for playing Miranda Sings, a fictional YouTube character meant to parody vapid pop singer type people. Ballinger has gone through a load of controversies due to her insanely questionable material and the really questionable things she did with children. Film Cooper, if you want to know more, Film Cooper made some videos talking about Miranda Sings. Definitely go watch those if you want to know more. He makes great content. Anyways, last year, she released this song as an apology. And the way the internet blew up after that is genuinely insane. Pretty much every commentary YouTuber under the sun talked about this apology. And the amount of memes and funny remixes we got from it was friggin' crazy and awesome. Which is probably the only reason, which is one of the reasons this song isn't any higher than number 3. And after listening to the song, dubbed Toxic Gossip Train, you can see why, because woof. Now, I'm going to skip the production and vocals because the production is just a simple ukulele strumming that doesn't even go on throughout the entire song. And Colleen's voice is fine. Not great, not terrible, just perfectly listenable, but a voice that you'd forget about hearing immediately after you hear it. And the main reason this song is so bad is because of the lyrics. Now, as I said before, Toxic Gossip Train is meant to be an apology for all the messed up stuff Colleen has done. So you'd expect the lyrics to be, you know, an apology. But nope! The entirety of Toxic Gossip Train is basically just Colleen going, la 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 la, I'm an amazing, virtuous person who did nothing wrong. I'm not going to apologize for anything. I'm the greatest. Nothing's wrong with my fault. The people accusing me are just lies and haters. La la la, I'm an amazing person. I did nothing wrong. I'm just an innocent little loser. You're all just hating. I'm the best person in the world. Like, even the worst YouTube apologies will have an I'm sorry. Or at the very least, acknowledge the wrongdoing that was happening. Whereas Colleen's little song is basically just an attempt at gaslighting her audience and whoever's watching the video and completely navigating around the awful stuff she did just so she can play innocent and pretend she's the victim, which she definitely isn't. Her antics have been documented and categorized by various people and even bleeds into her work as Miranda Sings. But she's pretending that it doesn't exist, that she's just an innocent little girl and that people are just being meanie heads. No, Colleen, nobody is being a meanie head. You are a creepy weirdo who needs to be called out. Put the ukulele away and take some accountability. Oh, and the cherry on top of this awful sundae, when people use audio of Toxic Gossip Train to call Colleen out on her BS and make fun of her, she actually had the gall to try and get the song copyrighted so that they couldn't use the audio. Yeah, I'll just let this clip of Elon Musk sum up my feelings on that.
Go yourself. Is that clear? I hope it is.
Bottom line, Toxic Gossip Train is genuinely disgusting. While on a musical level it's passable, the lyrics are absolutely ugly, revealing an incredibly toxic person who, rather than taking accountability for her actions, decided to sing her way out of accountability and blame everyone but herself. The previous songs I talked about, both in this video and in part one, were just bad songs. But TGT is morally reprehensible, and it's no wonder that it dominated the internet, because it's that, just that bad. And Colleen should take a ride on that toxic gossip train away from the internet, and especially away from children. next.
And that mistake doesn't make them a terrible human. It just makes them a human. But what do I know? Fuck me, right? The toxic gossip train. You're chugging down the tracks of misinformation. The toxic gossip train. You got a one-way ticket to manipulation station.
I have been waiting for a song from this man to end up on one of my worst lists for a long time. His music is so vapid, boring, and uncreative, and yet nothing he's made has ever pissed me off enough to put on an official worst list. But with this song, he's made a wrong move and ended up all the way on the top two. So it is with great excitement that I say the following. Welcome to my worst songs of 2023 list, Jason Aldean.
We'll try that in a small town. See how far you make it down the road. Around here we take care of our own. You cross that line, it won't take long for you.
Most of you probably saw this coming from a mile away. Both because every music critic under the sun has torn this song to shreds, and because I absolutely despise Jason Aldean. His music is some of the most uncreative and obnoxious drivel I have ever heard, to the point where I'm not unconvinced that he's secretly an AI programmed to make country music. Anyways, in 2023, Aldean released an absolutely abhorrent song titled Try That in a Small Town. And my God, does it absolutely suck. For starters, the production is garbage. The opening riff is fine, but after that, it's just obnoxiously dull and derivative butt rock covered in a thin country aesthetic. Admittedly, it's not the worst production of Aldean's discography, but even then, it's still insufferably generic and makes the song an absolute chore to listen to. Like, it's trying so hard to be passionate and anthemic, but at the same time sounds so lifeless and commercial that it just dilutes any attempt at passion this song could muster. As for Aldean himself, wow, he just does not care at all. Where Drake in Search and Rescue sounded like he was falling asleep, Aldean sounds like a country-themed ChatGPT, not evoking an ounce of passion or joy in his performance, and just going through the motions. As much as I hated Am I the Only One and Progress, I could believe that Aaron Lewis and John Rich actually believed the garbage they were spewing. But Jason clearly just does not care one inch, as he's singing in the most bland, dispassionate voice he can that just screams, I'm doing this for a paycheck. I've heard actual guest verses that are more passionate, lively, and interesting than Aldean's performance in the song. Although, to be honest, honestly, that's kind of par for the course for Jason Aldean, but still. Oh, and the fact that he isn't even from a small town certainly doesn't help his case. Finally, we have the lyrics, and I mean, it's a Jason Aldean song. Of course the lyrics suck. Here are the lyrics to Try That in a Small Town in a nutshell. Small towns are better than big cities because small towns are full of psychopaths that murder people for the most minor nonsense. And since I'm Jason Aldean and have a baked potato for a brain, I think that's a good thing. And sure, there are some pretty bad racist undertones to Try That in a Small Town, but honestly, I think the people getting mad about that, while their anger is justifiable, are giving the song way too much credit. Like, there are people calling this nothing pile of nothingness a lynching anthem. I'm sorry, calling Try That in a Small Town an anthem for anything is like calling a burnt black bean burger a gourmet steak. This song is not an anthem. It's just Jason rambling about, those darn city slickers are on my lawn again. I'm gonna go get my shotgun. I genuinely pity the people that actually sympathize and relate to the song, because they have to be the most brainless redneck NPCs I've ever seen in my life. But you want to know the worst part of this song? Well, as bad as the other songs on this list are, they only briefly touch the Hot 100, if they even touch the Hot 100 at all. Try that in a small town, though. Made it to number one. Granted, it plummeted immediately the week after, but that doesn't really matter. The damage was done, and Jason Aldean now has a number one hit. We live in a world where Money Trees, one of Kendrick Lamar's most iconic and awesome songs, never charted. But a pile of malformed trash masquerading as a small town anthem, written by one of the most talentless people in the music industry, got to number one. Where a ton of actually good, and interestingly bad, songs languished on the charts, or didn't get in at all, TTIAST got to number one through grifting off conservative outrage and left-leaning people falling for obvious bait. The people who got this song to number one don't care about Jason Aldean or his music, as evidenced by the fact that the album this song was on, Highway Desperado, a name way too cool to belong to a Jason Aldean album, flopped miserably. They just like that the song triggered idiots like the Young Turks, who are basically the left-leaning version of Fox News, and so astroturfed it to success. Which is honestly more gross than any bigotry the song itself might contain. Bottom line, Try That in a Small Town is just a nothing song pretending to be a racist one. The production is bland. Jason Aldean is bland. The lyrics are bland. It's just bland all around. It's a bland, basic nothing burger of a song that tried to get attention by saying a bunch of off-color nonsense it doesn't honestly believe and unfortunately succeeded. I know that some of you probably guessed this song would be my number one, but there are three reasons why it's not. One, it would be too obvious. Two, I didn't want to give this song the satisfaction of being my worst song of 2023. And three, at least this song has the courtesy to hide its bigotry, unlike my actual number one, which wears its bigotry like a badge. More on that later. But make no mistake, I still hate Try That in a Small Town with every fiber of my being, and I hope Jason Aldean never gets a number one hit ever again. Maybe he should try making music that doesn't suck in that small town of his. And before we get to the song that managed to piss me off more than Try That in a Small Town, here are some dishonorable mentions.
Remember the swamp? Remember my song in the swamp when I was like, wham, chicka, wham, wham, chicka, wham, wham.
I remember.
Well, ever since, the what's his name, the guy with the hair and the shirt.
The prince.
Yeah, the prince.
I like Awkwafina. I think she's a fairly solid comedian, and she was one of the few good parts of Crazy Rich Asians. That being said, Awkwafina trying to lyrical miracle rap while squawking like a bird is one of the most painful things I've ever heard. And it doesn't help that it's attached to yet another unnecessary Disney live-action remake that nobody asked for. Thank God Awkwafina had Quiz Lady and Renfield to fall back on in 2023.
They say they don't fuck with me, but I say they can't fuck with me. They like the air, I'm everywhere. How you say it, so me.
Another obnoxious and generic Glorilla song, but this time with Cardi B. Blech. While Cinderella Snapped is a horrendous song with awful production, obnoxious vocals, and hilariously inept lyrics, I left it off the official list because, unlike most of the songs that actually made it on here, Cinderella Snapped was at the very least made with good intentions. Jax clearly has her heart in the right place, and does genuinely want to make empowering feminist songs, but the problem is her lyricism is so inept that it causes the messages to become muddled. I genuinely hope Jax manages to improve her lyrical skills and make some genuinely good feminist anthems, because tracks like Cinderella Snapped are certainly not helping the feminist cause. Beauty realized that she was the beast. What does that even mean?
The waiting, the gazing, the painting, the raging, the raving, the pacing, the praying, the shaking.
The sample of When the Party's Over by Billie Eilish is absolutely horrendous, but aside from that, there's nothing really to say about this song.
Shit with leaking, ooh, juice. Shit with peachy, just like the fruit. She say that shit with fruit. I say that shit with goose.
An ugly and generic pile of sludge that barely qualifies as music. Oh, and that title is stupid. Get it? Because peaches and eggplants are euphemisms for privates. Ha 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 ha, that's so funny. Ugh.
Speak to me, you body lightweight. Speaks to me, I don't know what you need. Get to me.
If a Chris Brown song had to chart, could it at least be one of his good ones rather than a lifeless deep cut from an extended edition of his 2019 album? Good God.
Like sex in your car, cause you know it might hurt. I'm not the first one, baby. Yes, that's the way when you fall out of love. Sometimes the wrong person does more than enough.
I found out about this song from Finn from The Social Tune, who listed it as his worst song of 2023. And while I don't hate this nearly as much as Finn does, it's still pretty bad. The production is limp, Kian's voice is insanely bland, and the lyrics are toxic, poorly written, and gaslighty as hell. Finn does a great job analyzing the song's problems and tearing it to shreds in part 2 of his Worst Songs of 2023 video, so if you want a more in-depth look at why Everyone Who Falls in Love sucks so much, go watch that video. Tell him Jeremy sent ya.
I'm a diamond in the rough, baby. I like my sex to be rough, baby. Go crazy with that head. Make me scream in bed. She a Tyrannosaurus when she off the meds, and I'm hanging off a thread. Hopefully I'm not dead when this releases.
In the process of making this video, I was looking up various other worst songs of 2023 lists to find dishonorable mentions, because most of the songs that a lot of other people hated this year were songs that I actually liked, or songs that I thought were just whatever. While doing so, I came across this song, and I mean...
Keep my name out your fucking mouth on some Will Smith shit. Murk my ex bitch on some Kill Bill shit. I'm gonna make out the Sinnoh rap on some Jack and Jill shit.
Do I even need to say anything? Like, what even is there to comment on with this thing? It's literally just a generic AI voice saying stupid lines over a grungy and murky beat for 2 minutes. This is like Tony Zaret levels of meta irony. I'm not even mad, I don't even know. Still more of a song than Peaches and Eggplants, though. On its own, Miss You is a mediocre dance remix of an okay Oliver Tree song. But when combined with how Oliver and Robin basically stole South Star's remix and repackaged it as their own with very minimal changes, it just makes this insanely scummy. The only good thing about Miss You is the music video, but that's only because Oliver Tree is an awesome music video director. Disappointing scumbaggery from an artist I really like.
Wake up and munch it, let me pull your hair, take off that bun. Don't catch me speaking on no M, nigga, you ain't gonna know if I done done it.
A crushingly dull song from a crushingly dull rapper, with obnoxious production, grating vocals from Moneybagg Yo, generic lyrics, a forgettable future verse. Absolutely worthless. Although there's another song also named Keep It Low, made by the singer named Martis, that's actually really good. Listen to that instead.
Mr. Big Boy, pulling up in your big toy, saying all that blah, 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 making all that big noise, cause you're so frustrated, emasculated.
Mother by Meghan Trainor. Where do I even start with this absolute fever dream of a song. From the insanely tacky, the fact that Meghan Trainor is literally mother right now, vocal sample at the beginning, to the hilariously terrible sample of Mr. Sandman by the Cordettes that somehow sounded less silly when Young Gravy sampled it, to Meghan Trainor's catty delivery, to some of the most inept lyrics you will hear all year, to the music video, which has a prominent appearance from Kris Jenner for some reason, Mother is just an absolutely head-scratching mess. And I kind of love it for that. Like, don't get me wrong, this song is undeniably awful, but compared to so much of bad 2023 music, which was just disposable nothing, Mother feels like finding a gigantic jug of lemonade after crawling through a barren desert for months. Just absolute insanity from beginning to end. And while we're on the subject of insane sampled tracks,
I'm sliding with the hoes, I got two in the whip. Water faucet leaking, I come through with the drip. If you seen her with the guys, you better knew she was lit. A real toxic, I'll fuck around and ruin a bitch.
No, your ears are not deceiving you. That is a hip-hop song that is unironically sampling Hey Soul Sister by Train. And not just that, they are interpolating Pat Monahan's Haze into the lyrics. That is honestly amazing. And don't even get me started on these lyrics. They are genuinely some of the most insane attempts at wordplay I have ever seen. This is an actual line from the song. With my son in the crib, watching Happy Feet, his mama came in, I put him out, now I got Happy Meat. That is a real lyric, said by a grown man, in a hip-hop song, sampling Hey Soul Sister by Train. That's real, that lives with us on Earth! So yeah, Hey Hey by Polo Frost and DFB to Pac-Man is a terrible song from literally every single objective standpoint, but it is so amazingly and amazing and astounding in its terribleness that I honestly respect it. Polo and Pac-Man, I don't know if you're watching this video, but thank you. Thank you so much for bringing this amazing pile of awfulness. And now number one.
Mistake doesn't make them a terrible human. It just makes them a human. But what do I know? Fuck me, right?
For the longest time, I had no idea what to do with this song. I considered making it a dishonorable mention, or not mentioning it, because that would be giving it what it wants. But then I realized, no. There was no song this year that pissed me off more than this song. I don't care if I'm feeding into the bait. It deserves to be my worst song of 2023. So what song could that possibly be? Well, allow me the displeasure of introducing to you all a little ditty known as Boycott Target.
Target, Target, yeah they target and Target, Target, yeah they target kids. Target, Target, yeah they target and Target, Target.
Boycott Target is basically everything I hated about Try That in a Small Town, but multiplied by 10. Everything about it is so lazy, bigoted, and effortless that it creates a perfect storm of awful that makes it so much worse than the previous 9 songs I talked about. Let's start with the production, and wow, you guys just did not even try. It's just an incredibly shaky piano and drums with annoying trap skitters and no melody whatsoever. Like, as lazy as Try That in a Small Town's production is, at the very least, they somewhat tried to make it sound anthemic. Meanwhile, this production just sounds like they took a stock piano, drum, and trap beat, put it on a loop, and called it a day. But believe me, that's the least of this production's problems. As for the artists themselves, yeah, they suck. They have the most pedestrian rap flows imaginable, to the point where they're barely above just talking while the music plays. They have insanely unlikable auras, and don't even get me started on this idiot, who, as opposed to rapping, tries to do this stupid church choir singing to make the song sound more deep, but it just makes the song sound more annoying. All around, just genuinely awful performances. But then, we have the lyrics. Now, before I get into these awful, awful lyrics, a bit of context. So a while back, Target got into a bunch of hot water from a certain group of people because they decided to sell some Pride merch for Pride Month. Anna Marie Forcino has a great video called How the Woke Stole Christmas that goes more in depth on that and other Target LGBTQ controversies if you want to know more. But the TLDR version is, Target sell gay things, that makes these idiots mad, they made a song about it. And given that context, you can imagine, yeah, these lyrics are just insanely, openly bigoted. Again, with Try That in a Small Town, you at least could make the argument that it isn't bigoted. Here though, nope. Like I said earlier, Boycott Target wears its bigotry like a badge, and it's honestly disgusting. In addition to abusing the targeting pun to an annoying degree, the lyrics to Boycott Target express openly terrible anti-LGBTQ sentiments, lazy fear-mongering about pride clothing and children's sections, the horror mentions tuck-friendly swimsuits for children, which has literally been debunked, and in that choir section I mentioned earlier, the dude literally says, "We need to clean up on every aisle. Inside this store, Satan resides. Wash it with the blood of Christ."
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
Ah, yes. These people clearly care about the well-being of their kids. But what really makes this song my number one worst song of 2023 is how freaking lazy it is. Sure, the song is bigoted, but there were a ton of bigoted songs this year. And if this list was based on what song made me the most angry because of its bigotry, I would have given it to that awful Lil Nas X diss track Bryson Gray made, which was so heinous I didn't even want to put it as a dishonorable mention. But at least, as much as it pains me to give that horrific trash any ounce of credit, Bryson put some effort into that heap of trash. Whereas these idiots, who you might have noticed that I haven't said their names throughout this segment, and I never will say their names, because I don't respect them enough to do so, and I've already given them enough attention as is, made a ramshackled, lazy pile of trash that was made to cash in on a flash-in-the-pan controversy, and as such, is basically worthless now. However, there is one good thing this song gave us: hate comments. So before I give my verdict on this pile of trash, let's have some fun as I read off some of my favorite hate comments from under the Boycott Target music video. Good grief, these clowns sound worse than a public restroom filled with guys who all have massive diarrhea. I'm pretty sure they didn't reach the targeted demographic since alcohol and tampons are not for children. This song is one of all time. These dudes are definitely effing each other. This song sounds like a colonoscopy fart. Google it. I will not. How do all of them look like Nikocado Avocado from alternate universes? Yeah, we're still here. Thanks for the free publicity. As a lesbian, I can confirm that Target targeted me. I saw a rainbow wine bottle and immediately started kissing the woman next to me. Thanks for spreading awareness, King. They're targeting kids, zooms in on alcohol. This song goes so hard, especially the part where the song ends. I love that the most viewed part of the video is the first second, meaning most people were like, nah, and watch something else. 0% drugs, 0% girls, 0% effort, just straight garbage. Was teaching my son to walk, and he got right up to turn this garbage off. These guys are what foreigners think Americans look like. DJ Khaled never been the same since he came back to actually rap. This makes me want to sign you to We The Worst Music. Thanks to everyone who wrote those comments and other hate comments under that video, you guys made an awful song slightly more bearable. Bottom line, Boycott Target is a worthless pile of worthlessness. The production is lazy, the rappers have some of the worst flows I've ever heard, and the lyrics are bigoted trash. Everything about this song just pisses me off in a way that no other song from 2023 managed to do. Try that in a small town, maybe awful grifting garbage made by one of the most talentless people in the music industry. But at least I get the feeling that someone working on that song might have cared like a single iota. Whereas literally nobody on Boycott Target even cared one bit. It's lazy, grifting garbage that was made to cash in on a culture war talking point that was dated the second people stopped caring about Target. Because all these idiots cared about was getting clicks from people obsessed with a store daring to sell rainbow colored items. It's lazy, uncreative, bland, and horrible on every level. Perfectly reflective of the bland horribleness that was the 2023 music scene. And that is why Boycott Target by four lunkheads who don't deserve any respect is my pick for the worst song of 2023. Let this ugly slop rot in the dustbin of history where it belongs.
Target, Target, yeah they talking kids.
And that concludes my worst list for 2023. Sorry it took me so long to make this. I've just been so busy. Anyways, my top 10 best songs of 2023, part 1 and 2, and the worst and best albums list will be out soon. Stay tuned. But in the meantime, thanks for watching, and I cannot wait to talk about the good stuff 2023 gave us.